Hello, dear viewers. When discussing the potential for silicon-based life forms, both refer to period 4 of the periodic table. It is important to understand the basic chemical properties and similarities between silicon and carbon in the group. These elements have remarkable chemical similarities due to their valence electron configurations, which enable them to form 4 covalent bonds with other atoms. This similarity raises a compelling question in astrobiology and theoretical chemistry. Could silicon, like carbon, underlie life elsewhere in the universe? Carbon and silicon can form stable bonds with various other elements, including oxygen, leading to the formation of polymers, long-chain molecules that are vital to life as we understand it. But oxygen reactions exemplify a fundamental difference that is vital to this discussion. Carbon typically forms gaseous carbon dioxide upon oxidation, while silicon reacts with oxygen to form solid silicon dioxide, SiO2, commonly known as silica. This difference is critical. Silica's solid form makes it less flexible and more difficult to participate in the dynamic chemical changes necessary for biological processes. Silica formation gives rise to structures such as quartz or various silicates found in minerals such as feldspar, mica, zeolites, and talc. These are all hard and rigid materials that pose significant limitations to potential biological processes that require frequent recycling and restructuring of molecules, as observed in carbon-based life. Energy storage and manipulation are other areas where carbon and silicon differ significantly. In carbon-based life, energy is stored in various carbohydrate molecules that can be easily broken down and rearranged to release energy when needed. This process is facilitated by enzymes, which are themselves complex molecules that can selectively interact with large, specific substrates. This property is made possible by carbon's ability to form diverse and flexible molecular structures, including rings and long chains, through catenation. However, silicon does not easily form similar complex structures with the same versatility. Its compounds tend to be more rigid and less diverse, making the synthesis of enzyme-like catalysts that can facilitate a wide variety of biochemical reactions unlikely. Moreover, the lack of chirality in silicon compounds, a property necessary for the specificity of many biological reactions, further limits silicon's potential to form the basis of life. Despite these difficulties, the field of silicon chemistry is advancing and investigating the synthesis of more complex silicon-containing compounds. Since the pioneering work of Frederick Stanley Kipping, chemists have been experimenting with silicon analogs of traditional carbon compounds. However, these compounds generally remain less stable and more reactive than their carbon counterparts. This is constrained by the laws of thermodynamics, which suggest that complex, stable, life-sustaining silicon-based systems are unlikely to exist. From a theoretical perspective, one can imagine silicon-based micro or nanostructures that perform lifelike functions such as solar energy conversion or mechanical movements in highly controlled environments. However, the transition from these structures to a self-sufficient, self-replicating life form poses significant chemical and thermodynamic obstacles. An intriguing aspect of the debate between silicon and carbon in the context of the origin of life on Earth concerns how the molecular asymmetry of life, its preference for right-handed carbohydrates and left-handed amino acids, may have been influenced by ancient mineral surfaces. Chirally selective silicon-containing minerals may be included here. This scenario suggests that although silicon itself did not form the backbone of life, its chemical properties may have influenced early chemical pathways that led to the dominance of carbon-based life. As a result, while the idea of silicon-based life forms is a fascinating theoretical brainstorm and a popular motif in science fiction, current understanding in chemistry and physics suggests that silicon is unlikely to support life forms in a way similar to carbon. However, exploring this possibility enriches our understanding of the potential variability and adaptability of life by highlighting the unique conditions that gave rise to carbon-based life as we know it today. Thanks for listening. Stay well.